Where going to, no sé, comparo abrazamiento. This part, we're going to implement big data, cloud service, and IoT. So for the big, we're going to start with the big data. We're going to use one server. Just I will click, just I don't know one server, and I have already a database created in there. So I will show you how you can do a big data. So to open the server, just go here and go to localhost and go to PHP admin, and we're going to use SQL and put root. That is the username. And here I have a small database that has customers, orders, and paths. So to create a database, just go and create new, and then you start insert data. You can do it manually, but if you know how to use SQL queries, it will help you to do it quickly. So to implement big data in this small database, so big data is like getting just specific information. So, but before to start to, I will show you how database works. Database has this table, this one, and this one. This one is all the components that have our database. So I will introduce you a query. Query is like create a set of commands that can get you only the things that you want. So how the query works. So I will show you in a moment. For example, if you want to add tables, you just can use that query with all the information. And here you have more add data to the customer, and you have the information to the postcode, the state, the city, the address. And you can use just adding this information to create a query. But we already created that one. So what I will show you is how the queries work. So we're going to do this one, query two, list customer first and last name address for our customer whose postcode is 3220. So I will show you how this one works. We're going to this one. And we're going to SQL. And we press Ctrl V. And we put go. And you can see that we only have two customers with 3 to 20 others. So how this one helps? So this one helps to find only the information that we want to find. And how in MySQL we can do that one is by creating queries like this one. So you could see how query works to implement with data. So I will just show you again. And here we have the only two customers that they have the postcode. So now we're going to with the IoT. So to implement IoT and cloud service, I am using Cisco Packet Tracer. It's a free tool that you can download from Cisco. And we're going to start with this one. This one is a small motion detector that can actually, if you press up, the camera will turn on and capture your image. So, but before I show you how it works, I will show you what did I need to configure this. So this one is a small like something that we can use in for security in our business or in our company. And it's working by a server and using network. So I will show you how to configure this one. So first, what I did is I add the IP address of each device. So for the server, and how we do that, we go here, config, and here we add the IP address and we turn it on. We do the same for the camera. We go here, go config, interface, and you can see that I already have the IP address for this one, that is 1.1.12, and you can see that it's on. Motion detector, config, interface, and here you can see that I already have the IP address, 1.1.1.3. I have the subnet as well for all the device, and you can see that it's on. So all the devices already have their IP address. So now what I did is I create a web server, but to do that, you need to do to here. Here, you need to do this one when you said IoT, Internet of Things, and click here, registration server. So once you done this one, click here on, you can see that I already have an admin password one. That means that we already created a web server. I already did, but what you have to do, I will show you what you have to do next. So you go to desktop. You go to the web browser and you type the IP address that is 1.1. Let's go. And you can see that because I already have an account, so I just need to type admin and password one, and just I need to sign in. But once you get to this step, you need to have this one, sign up and create an account. Once you click register server on, it will allow you to do this one, but because I already created, I just sign in. Here you can see that I have the webcam and the motion detecting already, but how did I connect those two devices in the web server? What I did is just, I go to the motion detector. And here in settings, I click in remote server, and then I add the server 1.1. That is the IP from the server, the username, and the password one. That is my connection. Then you need to click connect. If it shows you that it's refreshed, it's because you already connect with the server. And the same thing with the webcam. Now you need to go here and you need to do the same thing, remote server, click at the IP server, admin password one, and so you already are connected with the server. You don't have to do anything to the switch. The switch is only like remote connection. It's like connected straight away. You don't need to do anything. Even you don't need to touch it. So once you done that one, you're going to see that you have the webcam and the motion server already in your server. So that means that you actually can control the webcam and the motion. What is the second step? Is you create a condition. I already create the condition like enable yes, webcam no. Motion on is true, the set webcam is on. Webcam off, motion off is false, set can on to false. So I will just show you what I did. First, you need to add a name, and it's good that you put like webcam on. So when the webcam is on, you put the condition if motion on is true, then webcam on true. So Here it's important as well that you actually type a name in each device. So all the device like motion, webcam, and server. So you actually can find it in the server like this. So like if you click here, you will see the names and everything. So webcam on is true. So here we are telling you that when the motion is on, the webcam will be on. And here we add another condition, another rule, that in this case here we type in the webcam off, and we put motion on is false. That means when the motion is off, webcam on is false. So that means that the webcam we will turn off on. So we already created these simple rules and conditions. So now we're going to see how this one works. So we're going to the server actually. We put that in there. Admin. Here you have the webcam, but to activate the motion server, you need to press the keyboard Alt, and here you can see that the webcam is activated, and he already catch on an image, a person getting in. You can see that the webcam is on, and if we do it again. So how this small project can be helpful in your business, like it can be for security, it can capture every person that is entering, and you can add more rules if you want, like you want to capture the time or something more complex. So this one is how IoT can be implemented in a small business. So to use that, we just use Packet Tracer and to implement Internet of Things. So now we're going to cloud service. So as I told you before, cloud service is something that allows you to be in another place, like work from home or from another place. In this case, we set up a really small networks from El Salvador, United States, and Australia. So sorry for that. So now we're going to show how we can communicate between Australia, El Salvador, and United States. El Salvador is my home country, Australia and America. So we are like setting on a small company, and they have locations in those three countries, but they want to communicate between each other, so we add a cloud service for that. So here we go. This one is the router IP address for the fast internet. Here you can see USA, El Salvador, for the router from Australia, the America, and El Salvador. And you can see the PC as well, and the wireless LAN, that is 10.0.1, 10.0.4 from USA, and 10.2. So how do we start configuring this? We go to the router, we go to config, we go to fast internet 0, and we add the IP address from we make sure that the router is on, and we have the IP address that is 11.1 from Australia, and you can see that it's already at. Then we go to the serial port. In this case, it's serial 2. When you connect, you make sure that you use the right cable and you connect to the right port as well. We can see that it's 10.1.25.20. So we do the same with the other routers. Yes, serial 2 is 10.2 from El Salvador. And the fast Ethernet is .1, and you can see here. Then you add the IP address from the PC, and you just go here. 1.2, that is this one from Australia, the user from Australia. And you do the same thing from the router and the PC. You do the same thing. Now we're going to the cloud now, and from the cloud, you need to do a couple of things. Like now, first things, is like something that I forgot to tell you is like this one doesn't have only have 3 ports. So what we did is we add another port. So to do that, just you need to turn it off, and then take out one of the other ports that actually is not doing anything, and just add another port. But I won't do it because otherwise I will lose the connection of everything. So that's why I won't do it. So then you go to serial 1 and you create ESNI, you put a name, in this case I put 401, and then you create in which one you want the communication. So in this one, this one is the router from Australia. So I create a communication. I said that I want Australia ESA, Australia USA. And then I did the same from, well, you, for this project, we are using serial 1, serial 2, and serial 4. We are not using the other serial. So in serial 1, I put Australia ESA, Australia USA. In serial 2, ESA Australia, ESA USA. In serial 4, I put USA Australia and USA ESA. And I put this number, these numbers. So you type it here, and then you put the name, and you just click that. That's it. The second step is the frame relay. In this one, you will add serial 1, Australia ESA. Then you will do the same in this one, serial 2. I will just make it longer. ESA Australia. And you will add this one by using this one. In this case, I already done it. Then serial 1, Australia USA. Serial 4, Australia, USA, Australia. Serial 2, ESA, USA. Serial 4, USA, ESA. So you can see that here we have the front relay. So we are going to allow communication between all of these serial sports. We already put the name and which one they want to go. So now that we've done this, that we tell the cloud which ports they have to go, we need to go to go back to our routers again and do some the most important thing, that is the static root. So to do a static root is like, we are in El Salvador router, I will go to the Australia router, so to show you what we have to do. And we go to static. And you put the static network that you want to allow your router to communicate. So we need to tell the router which network can upset and is allowed to communicate. In this case, I put 2.0, that is the range network from the network from El Salvador. And I put 4.0, that is the range network from USA. So, and then in next hop, I have the wireless LAN network. And in this case, I will have the first one, the one from El Salvador, that is .2, and then the USA, that is .4. So this one is the fast Ethernet from USA, that is 4.0, that is the range. And I add the wireless LAN, that is 10.4. In El Salvador, I add the range of the IP address, that is 0. And I add as well the wireless LAN from El Salvador, that is 10.2. And I do the same from the other routers. I go static. And here you can see that I am in USA router. I have 1.10, that is the range from Australia. So you can see that is 1.1. And from El Salvador, that is 0, that is 0 from El Salvador. And I have the wireless LAN as well. Then something important that you need to do is, then here you need to type, to go to the serial port, you go like, you tell like, serial 2, or you put interface serial, or actually you can go here, serial 2, you go here, and you're in that serial, and you need to put encapsulation. Encapsulation relay. And then you please just click enter and it will activate the encapsulation. So just let me check. Frame relay, okay, yeah, it's that one. So just click here. Encapsulation frame. Encapsulation. Oh, sorry, I already. Yes, now in the router. And here you can see the only thing that you need to do is put this command to the router and it will activate the encapsulation. So actually it will just allow you to communicate between the cloud. But remember that you need to be in the router, so to be in the config of the router of this serial port, you just took it here and then go here, you're already in the serial port. But if you want to be in the fast internet 0, you go here and you are in the fast internet 0 as well. So and you do the same from the other routers. Now we are going to test communication between our networks. We go here, from here. Actually, we cannot see anything, but it's working. But to show you that it's working, we're going to go to desktop, command prompt, and we are going to pin all the PC addresses so we can check if there is communication. So I am in Australia user, and I will check. First thing, I will check my default gateway. And you can see that it's working. Now we're going to check pin the PC from USA. That is 4.2. And you can see that we have communication to USA. Then we're going to pin El Salvador, that is the user is 192.2. And we can see that we have communication with the PC from El Salvador. Now we're going to the PC from El Salvador and we'll do the same to check that we have communication. Command prompt. And now we type in first thing, moving our for gateway. I advise you to do that so you can check if everything is working from the beginning. Now we've been to USA. That is the PC is 4.2. The user PC from USA is 4.2. And we can see that we have communication as well. And now from the user from Australia, that is 1.2. And we can see that we have communication as well. Now the last test, it will be the computer from USA. We go to desktop, command prompt, in the default gateway first, 68.4.1. We have communication, 168.1.2, the user from the computer from Australia. We have communication. The user from El Salvador type 2. And we can see that we have communication as well. So this one is like a small implementation of a cloud service. We can see how three networks that are integrated or independent are communication together between the cloud service. So in here you can see which serial ports are up. We'll just click quickly, right? Yeah, it's telling you which ports are down and the DLC that we create. Here you can see, and which port as well. So in this implementation, we can see how cloud service can help us to communicate between each networks that can be in different countries as well. So like how the user can communicate with the user of El Salvador, or how Australia user can communicate with another user in USA. So this one is the implementation of cloud service, and you can see how useful it is to have a cloud service. And in the cloud, you can do like more things like access to the database, storage, and plenty of things that you can do, even application as well. So this one was our implementation of cloud service. In this video, we show you the implementation of IoT, cloud service, and big data. So hopefully you're finding this video helpful and good. So this one was our second part from our second assignment. So in the next part of the assignment, we're going to do another step, but from big data, IoT, and cloud service, we finished with this video. We finished with the implementation. And thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for watching this video. And see you later.